एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ कैम रुपनवर एंड आई एम टीचिंग यू सब्जेक्ट CHP 4101 फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री. वी हैव स्टार्टेड सेकेंड सेक्शन केमिकल काइनेटिक्स एंड रिएक्शन डायनामिक्स. फ्रॉम सेकेंड सेक्शन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर विच इज़ अ revision of all the topics which are related to the kinetics, that means recapitulation. In today's lecture we will see a second chapter, complex and simple reactions. At the rates of the complex and simple reactions, so here various types of reactions are given. Reactions approaching equilibrium, consecutive reactions, opposing reactions, chain reactions and the photochemical reactions. So among this, in today's lecture we will see only the reaction kinetics of a consecutive reactions. So we will start with it. So see, sequential are the consecutive reactions. The consecutive reactions means what? The reaction which proceeds through various steps. For example, consider a general reaction. A gives B and B gives C. So see here, we want only reactant A which will give a product C. But in between this, there is an intermediate. This is B. So the consecutive reaction means what? The reaction in which one or more intermediate steps are involved. And these are also known as sequential reactions. There is a sequence. A to B, then B to C, then C to D, D to E, and then product will be formed. Means in between reactant and product, there are so many steps that are the intermediates. So we will see a reaction kinetics of a consecutive reactions. See a general reaction. A gives B with rate K1 and B gives C with rate K2. So rates of reactions for A, B, C are written as. In the previous lecture I have told you how to write down a rate of reaction. So you can practice it and try to note down rates for this reaction individually. So rates for A, B and C are written as. First one is minus dA by dta. As I have explained earlier, when we are going to explain a rate for any reactant, the reactant is going to decrease or disappear. That's why its rate is negative. And other are forming. For example, A to B. B is formed. So formation rate is positive and the disappearing or decreasing or the disintegration rate is negative. So I have written here minus. Minus dA by dt is equal to K1 into concentration of A. So this is the first order reaction because concentration raised to 1 is there. This sign can be written at left side or at the right side. You can write this symbol or the sign at both sides as you want, either left or either right. Then rate for B. So dB by dt means rate of change of concentration of B with respect to change in time is equal to. See, initially B is forming with rate K1 and from which it is formed from A. So written K1 into concentration of A. Minus, this sign is negative, I have written here because B is going to decompose to form a product C. Means concentration of B goes on decreasing. So minus sign is here, rate is K2 and the species which is decreasing is B. So rate for B is dB by dt is equal to K1 into A minus K2 into B. This is our equation number 2. Then see, For C, we will write rate as dc by dt. Here, C is a product and which is equal to K2 into concentration of B. Then, see, this is the figure of a consecutive reaction. On the y-axis, there is a concentration. On the x-axis, there is a time. So, see, initially we have 100% A. As the time goes on, A is decreasing to form a intermediate species. At a certain time, intermediate species goes on decreasing and the product is forming. So, this is our consecutive reaction. In between reactant and product, there is another step is involved. This is a consecutive reaction. And here is the example or a nuclear reaction, which is an example of a consecutive reaction. Here, in nuclear reaction or a transuranic series, you know, there are several number of isotopes are involved in the series. Means these are the steps. From first isotope, second isotope is formed. From second, third isotope is formed either by alpha, beta and gamma emissions or the bombardments. So, see, here is the example. Lead with beta minus decay, it gives bismuth, then beta minus and formation of a polonium. So, see, this is a Pb to bismuth to polonium. We have to form only polonium from lead. But in between this, there is another species is present, another isotope is present, which is a bismuth, and this is called as a intermediate. And the intermediate containing reaction is an example of a consecutive reaction. Then we are going to integrate equation number 1, which is integrated in the first order reaction we have already. Also, see, this is our equation number 1, minus dA by dt is equal to K1 into concentration of A. So, minus dA divided by concentration of A, it's equal to K into dt. Put limits, after putting limits, equation comes, concentration of A is equal to concentration of A0 into e raised to minus K1t. So, this is our equation number 1, which is a integrated form here. Then, now, we will integrate equation number 2 and find out the concentration of B related to time t. So, this is the concentration of A, which is derived from equation number 1. And now, we are going to integrate equation number 2. See, here, this is our equation number 1 and this is 2. So, now we are going to integrate equation number 2. dB by dt is equal to K1 into concentration of A minus K2 into concentration of B. So, its integration is not so easy. So, we will see how this equation is integrated. So, dB by dt or d into concentration of B divided by dt is equal to K1 into concentration of A minus K2 into concentration of B. This is our equation. Then, equation 5 can be written as just transfer the negative side to the left side. So, equation becomes dB by dt plus K2 into concentration of B, which is equal to K1 into concentration of A. Both equations are same. Instead of writing the dB by dt plus K2 into concentration of B, I have taken initially K2 into concentration of B and then written dB by dt. So, this is our equation number 6, dB by dt plus K2 into concentration of B, which is equal to K1 into concentration of A. Now, we have the value of A, which is a integrated form of equation number 1. So, this is equation number 4. Concentration of A is equal to initial concentration into e raised to minus K1 into T. K is the rate constant and T is the time. So, just put this equation in equation number 6. Equation becomes dB by dt plus K2 into concentration of B. This left side of the equation remains as it is. which is equal to K1 as it is into concentration of A0 into e raised to minus k1t. This is our equation number 7. Integration of above equation is not possible as we are not able to separate the two variables concentration of B and time t. So integration of this equation is not so easy. Then we will multiply this equation number 7 by an integrating factor e raised to k2t. Which factor we are going to multiply by both sides? E raised to k2 into t on both sides of the equation number 7. So see, the equation number 7 becomes d into concentration of b divided by dt plus k2 into concentration of b into e raised to k2 into t, which is equal to, here left side is multiplied by e raised to k2 into t. Same way we are multiplying the right side with e raised to k2 into t. So see, our right side is k1 into concentration of a0 into e raised to minus k1 into t. Just write down here e raised to k2 t. So I have written here e raised to k2 t. So how this equation is written? K1 into concentration of A0 as it is. Both are e raised to powers, that's why written e raised to K2 minus K1 and outside the bracket T, because T is common in both the terms. So our equation 7 becomes dV by dt plus K2 into concentration of B into e raised to K2t is equal to k1 into concentration of a0 into e raised to in bracket k2 minus k1 into t. So this is our equation number 8. Now we can see that the left hand side of the equation is a differential of concentration of b into e raised to k2 into t. So we will write just this term here, dB or d into concentration of B into e raised to k2 t. Just take this term as it is here, because this is a differential form. So dB by dt into e raised to k2 t, this is our left side now, which is equal to the right side as it is, k1 into concentration of a0 into e raised to k2 minus k1 into t. Then just transfer this dt at the right side and write down the equation as d into concentration of b into e raised to k2 into t is equal to right side as it is, and just transfer this dt to the right side and note down here. This is our equation number 9. Then we are going to integrate the equation number 9 and just put limits 0 to t. So at the left side, d into concentration of b into e raised to k2 into t, this is our equation. Then to the right side, k1 into concentration of a0, because k1 is the rate constant and concentration of a0, which is the initial concentration. So these terms are out of the integration, and integration is just written and limits are 0 to t. E raised to k2 minus k1 into t into dt. So just for this equation, put here integration, and integration goes from 0 to t. Then the equation is simplified as, here left side comes because dB into e raised to k2 t, integration goes, left side remains as it is, which is equal to k1 into concentration of a0 as it is into, according to mathematical rules or the integration rules, e raised to ax comes e raised to AX divided by A. So, I have written here e raised to k2 minus k1 into t, this term as it is, divided by this term k2 minus k1. And now we will put limits. Limits are 0 to t. Then this left side remains as it is. Now at the right side, k1 into concentration of a0. This k2 minus k1, these are the constant terms or the rate constant. So just take this term at the outside of the integration value. So k1 into concentration of a0 divided by k2 minus k1 into the remaining terms in the bracket e raised to k2 minus k1 bracket complete and into t. So now we are going to put limits 0 to t. Initially we can put higher limit t is equal to t and next t is equal to 0. So this term remains as it is here, and here e raised to k2 minus k1 into t minus e0. So e0 value comes 1. So here only you can write, instead of e raised to 0, just value is 1. Now we have concentration of b into e raised to k2 t value is at the left side. Now just transfer this value to the right side. So at the left side there is a concentration of b, which is equal to, next terms are as it is, k1 into concentration of a0 divided by k2 minus k1. This term is also same here. Only this term is shifted to the right side. That's why here this term is positive, e raised to k2 t. When this term is transferred to the right side, it comes 1 upon e raised to k2 t. And 1 upon e raised to k2 t can be written as e raised to minus k2 t, because it is inverse. Then concentration of b is equal to k1 into concentration of a0 divided by k2 minus k1 as it is here into, in bracket. Now you have to multiply this term inside the bracket values. That's why I have written here how this bracket is solved. So e raised to, see, in all three terms t is common. So e raised to minus k2 plus k2 minus k1 and outside the bracket t, because all three terms contains t. Then e raised to minus k2t term is multiplied to this term also. So you can write here 1 into e raised to minus k2t is equal to e raised to minus k2 into t as it is. So minus k2 and plus k2, both terms get cancelled. So here only e raised to minus k1 into t remains, and minus e raised to minus k2 into t. So just I am going to write here, concentration of b is equal to k1 into concentration of a0 divided by k2 minus k1 into e raised to minus k2 plus k2 minus k1 into concentration of bracket is complete, sorry, into t minus e raised to minus k2 t. Same equation is I have written here. Therefore, the value of b is k1 into concentration of a0 divided by k2 minus k1 in a bracket. Now, e raised to minus k1 t minus e raised to minus k2 t. Now, we are going to find out the value of concentration of c. This is the value of b. We have initially value a is equal to a0 into e raised to minus k1 t. Now we have value of a and b. Now we are going to find out value of c, or the concentration of a product. So see, substitute equation 10 in equation number 3. Here we have value of b, and I have written The number of equation is 10. So just put this equation in equation number 3. So see, this is our equation number 3. dC by dt is equal to k2 into concentration of B. Now we have B value. That's why just put the value of B, which is calculated by us. So dC by dt is equal to k2 into concentration of B. Therefore, dC by dt is equal to k2 as it is, and just write down value of a B. Then, see, dC, just as the previous equation, transfer this dt value to the right side and write down the equation as it is. So, k1 into k2 into concentration of A0 divided by k2 minus k1 and this bracket as it is into dt. On integrating this equation number 11 and just put limits 0 to t. Therefore, integration of d into concentration of C is equal to k1 k2 into concentration of A0 divided by k2 minus k1 into, just put limits here, integration goes from 0 to t and brackets values are as it is, e raised to minus k1t minus e raised to minus k2t into dt. So just according to rule, e raised to minus ax, which is equal to e raised to minus ax as it is divided by minus a. This equation is simplified and then we will put limits. So see, concentration of C is equal to k1 k2 into concentration of A0 divided by k2 minus k1. The first term remains as it is, and in a bracket, as I have said, e raised to minus k1t divided by e raised to minus k1. Now we are going to put limits 0 to t minus e raised to minus k2t divided by minus k2. Limits are 0 to t and complete the brackets. Then this term remains as it is here. Then just after putting limits here, at once you can write down t is equal to t, and at the second you can write down t is equal to 0 for both the cases. That's why e raised to minus k1t when t is equal to t, and when e raised to minus 0 or only e raised to 0, the value will be 1. So e raised to minus k1t minus 1 divided by minus k1 as it is. And for the second bracket, sign remains as it is, minus. For second bracket again, put t is equal to t once, and then t is equal to 0. That's why e raised to minus k2t minus e raised to 0, that means 1. Then just sign is changed. This term remains as it is, and here is the minus sign, minus k1 and minus k2. Just transfer this sign to the upside. That's why the minus 1, which term becomes positive, and e raised to term becomes negative. That's why 1 minus, when this sign goes, the equation is written as 1 minus e raised to minus k1t divided by k1 minus, in second bracket, 1 minus e raised to minus k2t divided by k2, and complete the bracket. So now we have the value of concentration of C as concentration of A0 divided by k2 minus k1. So question is, where is the k1 and k2? So just multiply k1 and k2 into the brackets and write down concentration of A0 divided by k2 minus k1 at the outside of the bracket. So for this, first value, when k2 into k1, k1, k1 get cancelled when this term is multiplied inside, and k1, k1 get cancelled, that means k2 remains, and the remaining value is 1 minus e raised to minus k1 into t. Then for the second bracket, again multiply by K1 into K2. So just multiply this bracket by K1 into K2. K2, K2 get cancelled. Therefore, remaining term is K1. So K1 into 1 minus e raised to minus K2 into T. This is our equation 12, which is the concentration of C. Then, now we have to find out the time when the concentration of B is maximum. Means intermediate concentration is maximum at which time or at what time. So, we have to find out the maximum time for the maximum concentration of B. For this, we have to differentiate the equation number 10. For this, we have to differentiate equation number 10 and find out the d into concentration of B divided by dt and equate it to 0. Just I have written equation number 10 here, dB by dt is equal to k1 into concentration of A0 divided by k2 minus k1 into concentration of e raised to minus k1 t minus e raised to minus k2 t. This is equation number 10, which is I have taken from the previous. Then k1 into concentration of A0 divided by k2 minus k1 as it is. Then just taking derivative e raised to minus k1 t written as minus k1 into e raised to minus k1 t. For the second term, it is written as this power value is minus k2 t here into e raised to minus k2 t as it is. So, this is the differentiation of equation number 10. Then, this equation is again written as this left side is as it is. Then, minus k1 into e raised to minus k1 t. Here, minus minus sign is there. So, second term becomes positive plus k2 into e raised to minus k2 t. Now, according to steady state approximation, the rate of change of concentration of intermediate species which is considered equal to be 0. That's why I have written is equal to 0, and this is our equation number 13. So, k1 into concentration of A0 divided by k2 minus k1 into this bracket, which is equal to 0. Just when you can transfer this term to the right side, obviously it becomes 0. Then we have the equation k2 into e raised to minus k2 t. This minus equation is shifted to the right side. So minus k1 into e raised to minus k1 t is equal to minus k2 into e raised to minus k2 t. Minus minus terms becomes positive. That's why k1 into e raised to minus k1 t is equal to k2 into e raised to minus k2 t. This is our equation. That's why k1 upon k2, just transfer this here. K1 upon K2 is equal to e raised to minus K2 t divided by e raised to minus K1 t. As we have written in one equation, this reciprocal is written as e raised to K1 t because it is an inverse. Then e raised to K1 t into e raised to minus K2 t. T is common. So you can write this equation as K1 e raised to K1 minus K2 into t. So, just after taking log of both sides, E will be not there. That's why equation 14 is written as ln of k1 upon k2 is equal to k1 minus k2 in bracket into t. So, we have to find out the maximum time for the concentration of the intermediate when this is maximum. So, this is our t is our time. So t is equal to 1 upon k1 minus k2. Just shift this term to the left side. T max is equal to 1 upon k1 minus k2 into ln of k1 upon k2. This is our equation number 15. I substitute this equation number 15 in equation number 10 again. In this equation and take a differentiation and find out the value as B max or the maximum concentration of B is equal to concentration of A0 into K1 by K2 at bracket raised to K2 divided by K1 minus K2. So this is the rate of consecutive reaction. The consecutive reaction means what? The reaction in which the one or more intermediate steps are involved, and best example is the nuclear reaction. So we have to find out the concentration of each species which is involved in the intermediate steps or the reactant. So reactant concentration is found, then the intermediate concentration is found, then we have found the concentration of a product, and the maximum time required for the species B. So just go through it and try to solve the equation by yourself. Try to note down the rates of each steps.